start, obviously, offensively with the running back position, and then Nick Chubb and Sonny Michel and DeAndre Swift. They've got a stable of backs that are all explosive guys that have they've run the ball extremely well this year. I think the one thing you look at their offensive football team where they've improved from year one to year two is on their offensive line. I think they're blocking extremely well up front, getting a hat on a hat. They don't give up many negative plays or sacks. So it's a football team that's been very efficient offensively. Jake Fromm's done an outstanding job at the quarterback position of taking care of the football and managing their offense. He shows arm talent. He's been accurate with the football. When they've asked him to throw the football, you look at the Missouri game, I think there's four or five explosive plays on third down where he's creating explosives down the field against tight coverage. Really good playmakers on the perimeter, Terry Godwin and Ridley and Javon Wims, the guy we recruited here, obviously. Miko Hardman, who's done a really very nice job in their return game, but a guy that's they're getting the ball in his hands and a really good stable of tight ends with Nada and Warner and Blazevic and those guys. Defensively, again, a better season.
Yeah, I mean, runs so hard, just so physical. You know, small guy, but really puts all his effort and energy in every single run, and he's been that way ever since I've known him at practice and in the game. So it's just great to see him having a great year.
And how much does your running out of the RPOs kind of really help out the running game and give it a different dimension?
Yeah, it just keeps defense on their toes. You know, it may, like I said after the game, it may stop a guy's feet for a split second to let AJ and Tyson, you know, break an arm tackle. You know, instead of him being able to fall back in and get in on the tackle there, you know, maybe ran out with me on my fake or something. So just you know, trying to create more space for them to run through. You know, keeping myself, you know, around the guys and around our team and keeping everyone locked in and make sure what we're talking about in the locker room is the game. You know, what we're, you know, talking about in the meeting room is strictly the game. Staying locked in, staying focused on what we have to do. And I think the guys are doing a great job of that so far. Not getting wrapped up into any outside distractions, but really insulating themselves with the team and just focus on what we have to do.
I'd be bored out of my mind if I only threw it seven times a game.
Yeah, I mean, it's just the way that, you know, the offense is built. They got great running backs that are able to, you know, move the ball on the ground. And so if you're a quarterback in that system and that's what you're coached to do, that's what you do. And then if you're winning games and it works, you know, you don't say nothing. You just continue to do your job. I'm sure it's frustrating for him. I'm sure he wants to throw it more, but he understands that they're moving the ball on the ground effectively, that everyone keep doing what works. So.
Offense looks pretty cut and dry. Is that fair?
Yeah.
You know what they're going to do.
Yeah, I'm trying to run the ball.
How do you like that as the middle linebacker?
It's going to be fun. You know, trying to stop the run is going to be a challenge and something that I feel like we're going to do a pretty good job of.
Beyond those backs, why are they able to do it so well?
I think they have a good coach, and you know, the offensive line is pretty good. You know, the backs themselves, they're a really good back. So, you know, you combine all three and you have an issue in Georgia.
What percentage of snaps have you played this year?
I don't really know.
Almost all of them?
Yeah.
will this be a game you feel like you can do that just because of the physicality, or you think y'all will roll linebackers more than you have?
I'm not really sure. I think I'll be in for a lot of the snaps, but, you know, we haven't really talked about rotating or anything, no. So.
It's a great opportunity for us, you know, just to show that, you know, like, you know, we're a pretty good team. So we come out here and beat them, that'll be a good thing on the national stage.
Do you guys feel ready for that? I mean, you haven't had a game like this. Right. Mentally, are you guys ready to accept that challenge?
You know, we're getting more prepared as the week goes on. But by Saturday, you know, we'll be ready.
Do you guys think at all about how much it might, you know, shock the college football world if you were to pull off the upset, or is that not something we talk about at all?
That's not really something we talk about. Basically, you know, we just going in with the mindset, you know, just to win the game.
Obviously.
Do you know many guys on that roster?
I'm familiar with some, but I don't really know them personally.
Do you guys feel like there's any pressure on you guys? You've already clinched bowl eligibility. Georgia's obviously in the national championship, SEC East picture. Do you feel like there's any pressure on you guys to go down there, or do you feel like the pressure's kind of all on them to keep winning?
I feel like it is still some kind of pressure on us. Being that, you know, we can go out here and beat, we have the potential to beat them. So that's pretty much our pressure.
Tell them more, the DJ?